Danger, Tiger Crossing by Lynn Oliver. Chapter 5. We landed with a thud. Darkness was all around. Above me, I saw thousands of stairs climbing steeply up to nowhere. In front of me, I could barely make out what sounded like dark blue-black leaves. The ground felt soggy and wet beneath me. "Tiger, where are we?" Luna asked. "I'm not sure," I answered, "but there's only one way to find out." I tucked my helicopter into the pocket of my shorts so I could put both arms out in front of me. The air was hot. Heavy silver raindrops fell all around us, and as we took a few steps forward, the light grew bright enough for us to see that we were in the middle of a jungle. Tall trees with vines wrapped around their trunks surrounded us on all sides. "It's the jungle in the painting," Luna said. "It's exactly the same." "Do you think we're actually inside it?" I asked. Luna didn't answer. She just shivered with fear. That said it all. "See those red flowers over there?" she said. "They were in the painting next to the tiger." "The tiger? If we were truly in the painting, there would be a tiger. Where was he?" A sudden bolt of lightning flashed across the sky and lit up the face of the tiger. He was crouched behind a group of ferns at exactly the same spot where he was in the painting. His yellow eyes were glowing. His mouth was open. He looked hungry. "Is he real?" Luna said. The tiger sniffed the air. His yellow eyes followed even my slightest movement. "Oh, yeah, he's real all right," I whispered. "We need to get out of here now." I grabbed Luna's hand, and we took off running. The jungle was thick with trees and vines, ferns and flowers. The wind blew rain into our faces. I had no idea where we were going. I glanced behind. The tiger was following us across the jungle floor, breathing hard and showing his sharp teeth. One thing I know for sure, you can't outrun a tiger. They can run up to 35 miles per hour. If we were going to escape him, we had to think of something else. Luna knew that too. "Over there," she called out, pointing to a tall tree. "Let's climb to the top." "No good," I panted. I could barely talk because I was running so fast. "Tigers are cats. They climb trees." Up ahead, we saw a patch of waist-high, thick grass. We ducked behind it to catch our breath. It was quiet for the moment. There was no sound except the plop of the raindrops hitting the soggy ground. "I think he's gone," Luna whispered, peering out from behind the tangle of tall grass. "Maybe we lost him." A large striped paw suddenly shot through the thicket. Its long claws swiped at the air right next to our faces. "No!" I screamed. Without a word, Luna grabbed my hand and we bolted out of the grass deeper into the dark jungle. I didn't dare look behind me. I knew the tiger was there. He was so close I could hear him breathing. I didn't want to imagine his big black nostrils going in and out with each breath. "Look, a river," Luna cried. "I can see it beyond those trees." "We can make it there. Just put your head down and run." "Don't worry about me," she called. "I can run like the wind." And she did, her feathered hat flying in the air. The tiger was still close behind when we reached the banks of the river. Luna and I jumped into the water without a second thought. There could have been a million crocodiles in there, but we didn't care. We just wanted to escape the jaws of the tiger. When he saw us in the river, the tiger let out an angry roar. I started to shake, not from the cold, but just from being scared. "It's okay," Luna whispered to me. "We're safe, at least for now." "Not true." The tiger waded into the river and started paddling his way toward us. "I didn't know they could swim," I cried. "What do we do now?" "Swim faster," a voice called out. "I could have thought of that," I said to Luna.
"Thought of what? I didn't say anything."
"You didn't just say swim faster?"
"Nope."
I looked around to see whose voice I had heard, but I didn't see anyone. Was that voice coming from high in the treetops? Or was it coming from under the water? Or was I imagining it? I couldn't tell.
"Find the cave," the voice said.
I turned to Luna to see if she had heard it too, but she was already swimming toward the other side. I put my head into the water and took off after her.
With a tiger closing in on us, we had no choice. We had to swim for our lives.